Okay, let me explain to you what exactly is the financial asset from the definition of financial asset. Whenever we talk about the concept of financial asset, the definition of financial asset is that a financial asset is a cash. What is it? The financial asset is a cash. That's the first thing. And then what happens is it's a contractual right to receive cash. Now, that's a very important point which you need to understand. It's a contractual right to receive cash. Now, what happens is we have got prepaid rent. When we have got a prepaid rent, the prepaid rent is not a financial asset. Because why? The reason behind that is it is not a right to receive cash, but instead it's a right to utilize the premises. It's a right to utilize the premises. So if you have got a right to utilize the premises, that's an asset, which is not a financial asset. Similarly, you have got prepaid insurance. The same goes for this also. When you have got a prepaid insurance, the prepaid insurance is again a contractual right to avail the insurance facility. It's a contractual right to claim your loss in case if you have got a loss in front future. But it's not a contractual right to receive cash. So basically what happens is, what's a financial asset? A financial asset is a contractual right to receive cash. Now, there's another concept, which is basically income tax refundable. Now, if I talk about income tax refundable, so income tax refundable is a right to receive cash, but it is actually a legal right to receive cash. It is not a contractual right to receive cash. So if it's a legal right to receive cash, not a contractual right to receive cash, then it is not going to be a financial asset. So what is it going to be? It's going to be an asset under IAS 12. It's going to be an asset under IAS 12. Okay, the third thing is equity instruments of another entity. Now, what do you mean by equity instruments of another entity? So whenever we talk about the equity instrument, that would mean shares, that would mean share options. That is what is considered to be equity instruments. So other way around, if I try to explain to you people, it's actually going to be, if you invest in shares of another company, if you invest in shares of another company, then it is actually going to be considered as equity instrument of another entity. Then it is actually going to be considered as equity instrument of another entity. Okay, now, then lastly, it's contractual right to exchange financial assets under potentially favorable conditions. Now, let me try to explain to you this. I hope that a lot of you people have an idea about the options. I hope that a lot of you people have an idea about the options. Or I don't actually go into options. I would actually rather talk about the example of a forward contract. I would rather talk about the example of a forward contract. Now let's try to understand this. Now, so when I talk about this forward contract, so what exactly do you mean by the forward contract? So, for example, if you have entered into a contract to buy, let's say, if you have entered into a contract to buy, let's say, $100,000 by paying, let's say, at the rate of euro 0.9 let's say you have entered into a contract to buy $100,000 at the rate of euro 0.9. Now in the market, what actually happens is the exchange rate actually goes on like this. The exchange rate, which is euro upon dollar, goes up to 0.95. So even if the exchange rate goes up to 0.95, the applicable rate is going to be 0.9. The applicable rate is going to be 0.9. So if the applicable rate is going to be 0.9, so we are going to say that we have a contractual right. This forward contract is arising out of a contract which gives us a right to exchange financial asset under potentially favorable conditions. Under potentially favorable conditions. So that's what this forward contract is going to give you. It's actually going to give you a right to exchange financial assets under potentially favorable conditions. So that's the one thing which is about the financial asset. So I've actually explained to you what a financial asset is.